We're going to talk a little bit about derivative notation. In particular, how we use notation to tell us which variable we're taking the derivative in terms of, and what that means for other variables that might be in the problem. So, if we start at the beginning here, d dx of x to the fourth, that's easy. D dx means you're taking the derivative, and the variable is x, and you're taking the derivative of x to the fourth, which is just the power rule, that's 4x cubed. Now if we move on to d dx of f of x to the fourth, how do we find that derivative? Well, that derivative, it's the derivative in terms of x. You have some function of x raised to the fourth power. Well, this is a chain rule with an outside function up to the fourth power and an inside function of f of x. And even though we don't know what f of x is, we can apply the chain rule here. So we get 4 f of x, whatever it is, to the third times f prime of x. Okay, now this next one looks a little bit weird. It says d dx of y to the fourth. So we're asked to take the derivative in terms of x, but they don't give us any x's, they give us a y. So how do we interpret that? We interpret that as y being a function of x, y depending on x. So if that's the case, then this derivative is going to be just like this one up here. We're going to use the chain rule with the outside function being the fourth power again, and the inside function being y in terms of x. So we're going to get 4y, a function in terms of x, cubed, times the derivative of y in terms of x. Now that y prime, that doesn't really tell me I'm taking the derivative in terms of x, plus it kind of looks like y to the first power. So when we're doing these kinds of derivatives, it's strongly, strongly recommended that you actually write this as dy dx. That notation clearly says the derivative of y in terms of x. To review, anytime you have d something, the thing on top is the function, and the thing on the bottom is the variable. And it's assumed, if this is like dy dx, that y is a function, it depends on x. I guess maybe I shouldn't even say function, because we're going to use this in a minute for things where y isn't even a function. But even for those things where y is not a function, y is going to be related by an expression to x. So how does it change then if we say d dy? Well, if we say d dy of y to the fourth, now y is the variable, and y to the fourth is just like x to the fourth was before. We've just changed what letter we're using, but the problem is exactly the same. And so we're going to get 4y cubed, and that's it. But now down here, if we have d dy of x to the fourth, this problem is the same problem as d dx of y to the fourth. We have a variable down here that does not match the variable inside. So the assumption here is that x depends on y. And so when we take this derivative, we get 4x thought of as a function of y, the third, times the derivative of x with respect to y. Now the other thing to note here is that this will actually work even if there's no relationship. So if we are looking at, say, d dx of c to the fourth, then let's pretend that c is actually a constant. So it doesn't change as we change x. Maybe it actually depends on some other stuff. Maybe it changes as you change other letters. But as far as x is concerned, changing x does not change c. Well, what happens if we use the same pattern? We would get 4 c to the third times dc dx, the derivative of c with respect to x. Now, this doesn't look right because if c is a constant as far as x is concerned, if c isn't changing, then we know the derivative of a constant should be 0. So why are we getting this complicated expression? Well, it turns out this complicated expression is actually just a fancy way of writing 0. Because saying dc dx, how does c change as we change x? Well, if we're saying c doesn't change as we change x, this number is exactly 0. Therefore, we're looking at 4c cubed times 0, which equals 0. So we can use this idea of a chain rule, an inside function and an outside function, whenever we have different letters, no matter what that relationship is between those letters.